Frederick Griffith is thought to be the first person to demonstrate and document the process of bacterial transformation. Griffith conducted his famous experiments while attempting to find a vaccine for pneumonia. Today we can treat most cases of pneumonia with antibiotics, but in 1928, pneumonia was often deadly, even in otherwise healthy people. The Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria comes in several strains, and Griffith experimented with two of them. He used a virulent S strain with a smooth polysaccharide coat and a non-virulent R strain with a rough coat. The coating on the smooth strain protects it from the body's immune system and thus allows the bacteria to attack cells and cause disease. While observing the pneumococcus bacteria, Griffith noticed that sometimes the non-virulent R strain would revert into the virulent S strain. He theorized that a transforming principle was somehow transferred between the S strain and the R strain, causing the R strain to acquire dangerous properties. To test his theory, he injected five types of bacteria into groups of mice: a live R strain, a live S strain, heat-killed S strain, a combination of heat-killed S strain and live R strain, and finally S strain that had been isolated from mice in the fourth group. The results of Griffith's famous experiment would confirm the presence of a so-called transforming principle. Mice from group 1 who were injected with the non-virulent R strain survived, which is unsurprising given that the R strain is not dangerous. Also unsurprisingly, the mice in group 2 who were injected with the virulent S strain developed pneumonia and died. High temperatures kill most germs, which is why boiling something is often a cheap and effective way to sterilize it. Griffiths used heat to kill S strain bacteria, then injected these dead bacteria into a third group of mice. Even though they had received a dose of the dangerous S strain pneumococcus bacteria, these mice survived because the bacteria were all dead. The fourth group of mice was crucial to Griffith's experiment. He injected the mice with a combination of heat-killed virulent S strain and live innocuous R strain. The mice injected with the combination developed pneumonia and died. On their own, neither of these components should have been deadly, so Griffiths concluded that the live R strain had acquired some type of deadly component from the dead S strain. He called this mysterious component the transformation principle. Finally, Griffiths isolated bacteria from the blood of the fourth group of mice and found it to be identical to known samples of the deadly S strain pneumococcus bacteria. He confirmed this by injecting the isolated S strain into a fifth group of mice, which then developed pneumonia and died. The live R strain had transformed into S strain by acquiring some kind of dangerous properties from it. At the time of his experiment, the exact nature of this transforming principle was unknown to Griffith. It took almost 20 more years before Avery, MacLeod, and McCarty's work in 1944 confirmed that nucleic acids and not proteins are the molecules of heredity. However, Griffith's groundbreaking work proved that some organisms can acquire new properties from their environment and from one another, and also that non-heritable exchange of genetic information is possible. If you have questions about Griffith's experiment or about bacterial transformation, please check out the comment section, as viewers often ask and answer one another's questions in there. Feel free also to check out the study guide that's linked in the video description. Thanks again for watching, and please remember to like, comment, and subscribe.